So, hello everyone. Today I'm going to talk about how we introduced analytics in social skill CMS. So, I've mentioned my GitHub and Twitter handle there, so please feel free to reach out to me. So, the agenda for today would be to first I'll give you a brief about me, and then I'll give you a brief about the entire SUSE architecture, like what is SUSE and what are the several components and how everything's working. So after that, we'll look into React, what React is and how we use React to develop our UI solutions for SUSE and how it helped us to create really amazing web solutions. After that, we'll get into the SUSE Skill CMS, which is a branch of the SUSE web projects. So it mainly deals with skills and bots and all that stuff. It helps you manage it essentially. And after that, we'll get into how we introduce analytics in the CMS, so the skill creators and the users of the skill can get more analytical details about how the skill is performing and all that stuff. So let's get started. So first, I'll give you a brief about me. So I'm a pre-finally undergraduate student from IIIT Vadodara, India, and I'm presently pursuing computer science. So I started with software development in 2016 because I had a course where I had to create a web project, and then I started exploring various web aspects like HTML, CSS, JavaScript. So I created a really basic web project, and then I started learning about Git and GitHub and what it is and how it works. So that was really interesting, and I was really fascinated about the entire ecosystem, the web development ecosystem. So I continued with web development after that, and that was also the time when I started doing open source. And I created some basic projects of my own, and then I started contributing to various organizations as well. So FastSHA was one of them, and the projects were really easy to get started with. So I started contributing. First, I started with really basic contributions like updating documentation and fixing some really basic UI bug like that can be just fixed using some CSS. So I started with that, and then eventually my contributions grew and the quality also increased. So that was really nice, and that was a really learning experience for me, because that's from where I evolved and I got proficient in the web development. So in 2016, when I got into my university, I started exploring several programming languages and domains of programming. So web development was really interesting, as I said, and I also really like JavaScript, so I started exploring the JavaScript ecosystem. So, and I learned that there was a lot to the JavaScript ecosystem. So React was also really coming up at that time, so I started learning React as well. And then I contributed to several open source projects in FastSHA. I became a and I also participated in a contest called Hoodit by FastSHA in 2017. So I also emerged as a finalist winner, so that was really exciting. And then I got in, and then I got into JSOC 18 with FastSHA last year. So my project was to introduce analytics in the CMS, and I worked with in a team of three. So and my team members were Rakshat Garg and Anup Panwar, and all three of us worked into analytics part. So we handled everything from server to the front end and all of the analytics. And I really enjoy anime and football as well. So I really pursue my free time. So my journey with FastSHA started with really great projects that easy to get started with. So I found repositories, and then I used to set them, and then used to understand the code base, and then that got me really interested. And so eventually become a member of various programs that FastSHA has. So I participated in Code Heat, I participated as a GCM editor, and then I participated in JSOC finally last year. Project admins and managers are all able to help. So I'm facing like a newcomer in the community, so he said common that he can face some setting up issues or in my face. So the mentors are always available in the GitHub channel. We have a dedicated GitHub channel for all the projects, so people can just reach out there, and there's no, I mean, vouching system or anything like that. You can, if you want to just get started, you can just join the GitHub channel, open an issue, and open a pull request to just start your contribution. So that is really easy and amazing. So let's talk about SUSE now. So SUSE is basically a web framework. A framework to develop conversational solutions. So the great thing about SUSE is that it's open, and you can create your solutions on any platform. So we have platforms developed our on our own. So we have web clients, several web clients. We have mobile apps. We have bots, and then we have the smart speaker. That is the SUSE hardware. So the server is basically the entire brain of SUSE. So we have several clients, like the web clients, mobile apps, bots. All the clients communicate to the server via REST API. So the server exposes REST API endpoints. So the clients can just talk to the server using endpoints. So this is the entire wireframe about how everything's working. So as you can see, this is the brain, which is the server that we have hosted online. And then we have all these clients, which can talk to the server via an API request. And we have users who can just send a query via any client and then talk to the server using that. So we have all other setting and personalization and user data that is oriented for the user. So and then here we have the skill CMS, and here we have skills. So what basically a skill is, skills are something that is aggregated by the community. So the community works to gather skills, and skills is something that SUSE uses to respond to the user. So if you want to create a weather skill, so you can just create a weather skill, and then you'll be able to ask SUSE about what's the weather today. But we already have a weather skill, so I'm just giving an example. But if you want, like, the SUSE didn't have any skill to recommend anime, so the skill to recommend animes, and yeah, that was it. So it's really community oriented. So because open source is really driven by the community, and it takes a huge community effort to sustain open source. So if you want to improve any skill, you can just go to the skill CMS, register there, and then you can edit any skill as per your wish. So that is really amazing, and that also makes sure that all of the skills are fine tuned and they perform well. So let's talk about React now. So how many of you already know or heard of it? Okay, heard. So how many of you have used it before this? Okay, yeah, nice, amazing. So React is a JavaScript library for building user interfaces by Facebook. So, and the catch is that React is not a framework, because many people have a misconception that React is a framework, but it is a library, as Facebook says. So it follows the component-based pattern. So everything in React is a component, basically. So you can just compose components, and then you can create a UI solutions as per your wish. And React does the hard parts of managing state for your application. So you just have to focus on your UI, and then it will handle automatically to update and handle the DOM tree. So React makes it really simple to create UI solutions, and it's really extensible, and it's really easy to get started with as well. So another question that you may have is, why did you choose React? We wanted to try new things, firstly, because by the time we started with SUSE Web projects, we already had projects in Angular and Ember.js. So we but React was really emerging at that time, and it was really popular. And so we thought, why not, let's just start the SUSE apps family in React.js. And we also had contributors, great contributors at that time, so they were also really excited for choosing React as the web framework for this. So another some highlights that React has is it has easier state management for your application. So manage your state really efficiently. And then we have helper libraries like Redux and Flux as well. So Redux is basically like you have a centralized store for your application. So all of the data in an application is stored in a centralized store. And anywhere the data from the store is used. So if any component updates the store in the data, it will be updated throughout your DOM tree. So that is really amazing. So it also facilitates code sharing and code splitting. So because many people already have, so what you can do is you can just create a React component, and then you can code it anywhere, and it will work the same throughout any application that you use. So I've published a few React components on my own as well, like they're really basic components, but yeah, that's how it is. And we also have several UI libraries which offer great React components. So what you can do is you can just import that library, and then you can use the components from that library. So that is really cool. So let's get into what SUSE Web projects are. So all of the SUSE Web projects are in React. We have three web clients that we started some years back. So the first is the chat application. That is basically a chat window that you can use to interact with SUSE, and then you can just shoot in your queries to the SUSE server, and then the SUSE server will reply you appropriately. That we have the CMS. So it allows you to manage skills that the SUSE server uses, and then it allows you to manage and create bots as well. And then it also allows you to get the analytics about your skills. So you can know how many users your skill has and how like it, you have the rating. We have the rating system as well, and how many people are using it in various countries, and what is your skill used on. So all that analytics is also developed at the CMS. After that, we have the accounts web app, which is it basically handles stuff related to your account. So in SUSE, you can just register your account, and then you can manage your account from the accounts web app. So these are the three web apps that we started for SUSE. So let's get into CMS. So the CMS basically comprises of three things, that is skills management, bots management, and then it also provides you the analytics there. So the workflow for how we use the server to hook up our front end is that we have CRUD APIs on the server for various things, like you can we have APIs for authentication, we have APIs for getting a skill, we have APIs for sorting stuff and searching stuff. All that APIs are available on the SUSE server. So what we can do is we just import relevant components from the material UI library. So we are using material UI right now, but we are looking to port to our own components soon. So we just import components from the material UI library. We place them in the UI appropriately, like how we want to, as per the design spec, we just place them in the UI. We check responsiveness and fix all of the styling issues that we have. And then we just call the API from the server. We fetch our data, and then we input all of this data into our component. So that's how the front end and the server is connected. So yeah, basically the UI components that live on the front end consume data from the RESTful APIs that are exposed on the back ends. And API is written a JSON, standard JSON response with the requested data, and then this data is plugged into the components. So JSON is just a response format, and some people use XML as well, but I don't know the advantage of that, but okay. So let's do a quick example. This URL is a sample API call to the server. So if you just visit this URL, you'll get this kind of JSON response. So this JSON response has a key called skill rating, and then it has a key called stars, and then all of the stars are distributed in this fashion. So 1 star, 2 star, 3 star. So this is for getting data for any skill. So you just get the metadata for any skill, you get the skill rating in that data as well. So this is just a sample of that. So this is how we get data from the server, and then we just use this JSON data in the front end to fill in to the components. And for the request library, we recently ported to Axios. So and on the front end, once we have the data, we are using a library called Recharts right now, which provides charting solutions for various kind of charts like pie chart, bar chart, line chart, and all that stuff. So this is how the basic architecture looks like. For the ratings, we have using bar chart. So we just import bar chart from Recharts library, and then while in the render function, we just return this JSX. This renders a bar chart component from the Recharts. We fill in the data, which is equal to the ratings data that we fetched earlier, and then we just close this JSX tag. So this is the basic workflow about how everything's working. We fetch the data, we fetch the UI components from the libraries that we're using, and then we just hook all of this data together. So our app is rendered in that way. So let's get a quick insight into our code base. So this is the SUSE Skill CMS code base, and all this is majorly documentation. The main thing is the source folder, which has tests that contain the tests for our UI. It has the API folder, which mainly handles all of the API calls that we have. So as I said before, it has various API calls for authentication, for fetching your skills, for rating, and all that stuff. So after that, we have the components folder. So this basically contains all of our UI components that we are using in our UI. And after that, we have a helper folder, which contains all of our helper files. Like it has files for checking email, it checks your phone number, and all that stuff. After that, we have images that we are using on our front end. We have a Redux folder. So we recently ported to Redux because the app was getting really huge and the code base was really getting complicated. So it was really difficult for new contributors to get started with. So we recently ported to Redux